Hey there, welcome back to Midas Letter Live. My guest in this segment is somebody who's been here a couple of times before. You might recognize Vic Neufeld, CEO of Aphria. Vic, thanks for joining me again today.
And thanks for having me again. Thank you.
Hey, Vic, you came out with, by all accounts, a fantastic quarter. Why don't you give me the bright lights?
Well, in our definition, it was a healthy quarter. Mm-hmm. A lot of metrics were met and exceeded. Again, lowest cost producer status, I think, has been punctuated yet again. Cash cost actually went down a penny. It's really attributable to who we are growing in a greenhouse and our growers. But it's more than that. It's our revenues that continue to be properly balanced with our medical platform, but at the same time, making sure that we're loading up sort of in the vault for the recreational launch. So, yeah, and we made a lot of investments, both the marketing of the rec brand and investments therein, but also internationally. We're putting a lot of effort, which takes money, in the many countries we're in.
Yeah, so you've got your current global portfolio includes the United States, Australia, Germany, Malta, Lesotho, Italy, Colombia, Argentina, United Kingdom, and Uruguay. I think the U.S. is mistakenly here because you're not actually in the U.S. as Aphria, correct?
Correct.
Yeah, so that's that. But you're really everywhere. Which of these jurisdictions excites you most about the future?
About the future?
Yeah.
Wow, I've never had that question before. I like them all.
I've never asked it before.
There's some viewers who are probably going to say Jamaica, say Jamaica.
Right, right.
I think there's a couple that are of even importance to us. Germany, now that they have announced the relaunch of their tendering process, and our German team that we inherited from the Nuvera acquisition together with my team. Mm-hmm. Here at Aphria, are marching forward to re-engineer and fine-tune and really make sure that we hit it out of the park. Germany, the country, the population, the amount of chronic ailments that have been approved, and again, socialized medicine there,
sure.
It's a very, very important market.
How many patients in Germany right now, totally, in the whole system?
Oh, I think maybe 5,000.
It's still low.
Very low.
Oh, okay.
Very
so all low. The upsides yet in the future.
Absolutely.
That. Okay. Yep. Interesting.
The other country, though, and I kind of want to not correct you because I hate correcting a moderator, but the U.S., we still have the ownership of Liberty in escrow, which is subject to different vend-out programs going forward as they get released. But the U.S. market is of great excitement. Mm-hmm. That's why we as an Aphria continue to support Liberty in certain aspects where we can in full compliancy of the TSX undertakings we gave them. The CBD hemp farm bill being moved with bipartisan support into the White House by the fall of this year is what we think is just the beginning of what's going to be happening. And once that goes from Schedule 1 to Schedule 2, CBD, that is, from hemp, it's the beginning of the transition. Could take 2, 3, 4 years to finally get to where Canada is. I'm not even looking that far. Just give me medical across the federal boundaries.
Yeah.
It's huge. It's huge. And it just punctuates the reason why we even began the journey with the state of Florida.
Very cool. What about Brazil and Colombia and all of Latin America? I mean, what is it, 540 million people in that area? If you do the percentages, that implies easy low-hanging fruit, 5.4 million cannabis users on the medical side. So, I mean, that's got to be cause for excitement.
So we began our journey of understanding LATAM with Argentina. And it was over a year ago that I personally made my first of two trips there. And very important to understand, where is the Ministry of Health? Where's their head at? Where's the population going in terms of, in this case for Argentina, epileptic seizure control and what evolves, whether chronic ailments, pain management, et cetera, going forward. And establishing the credentials, establishing relationships, understanding and presenting the Aphria story to them, the quality, the GMPs, et cetera. And so we got really, really excited with Argentina. From my Jameson days, I know it takes 1 to 2 years of preceding activities and minor investments before the government's ready to act, mm-hmm. while they're acting now. So their order to us is already with Health Canada, this infamous wait 45 days. Therein lies the beginning of some really, really good EBITDA positive, significant turning into material business opportunity, Argentina. Colombia. Colombia today, CBD is now like an OTC product. If you wanted to do a THC, there's a special license, which Colcana, Scythian, but by after the closing will be Aphria, just got that final license. So we have all three licenses now in Colombia that allows THC through doctor scripting. It's 50 million people. One could talk about the poverty levels, the GDP's minor inflation, the growth of 2-2.5%. I mean, it's not that it's a country that is going down the tubes, and it's not a China with 12% growth. But in between, it's a country that really is central to the health Department of Health regulations, because as Colombia goes, so will other countries, namely Brazil. And Brazil is really the home run. They have moved 100, well, maybe 90 degrees in just the last month.
Really?
The last month they have moved and now talked about the importation of CBD oils, again being our Redu oil that's being sold into Argentina, out of the box into Colombia, and hopefully Brazil, and we make an application there. So this whole acquisition we made for, and just to be clear, Aphria Value paid $160 million for three countries, Argentina, Colombia, Jamaica, and a ROFR for Brazil. To put that in perspective, three countries plus the ROFR, there was one company that went public 2 months ago with a $300 million market cap for one country called Colombia. Another LP last month made an acquisition for $150 million US for one country called Colombia. I bought for $160 million. Three countries plus a ROFR on what really is the gem of South America called Brazil. So I rest my case when there's any investors that think I've overpaid or am in doing something that is not in proper care keeping of Aphria assets, I beg to differ.
Right. Okay, interesting. Now, coming back to Canada, you included the information that you're on track to be producing 255,000 kilograms by January 2019. That's astounding. That's a tremendous amount of kilograms. Let me ask you, what do you think your average price per kilogram is going to be? This is post-recreational onset in Canada, but what's the average price per kilogram that you're going to sort of target and say, I think that's what we're going to get?
You want me to give forward guidance here, James.
Darn, okay. You caught me.
No, but I'll give you high level. But I just want to add the clarity to your viewers. It is our firm belief and expectation, sometime end of September to mid of October, we will have completed the construction of Part 4 of Part 5 at Aphria 1 and the retrofit of Aphria Diamond. We have given ourselves 2 months for Health Canada come in on-site inspection. If we err in some timing, it's Health Canada, we've given 2 months. We say 2 months because prior to that, we are then going to start loading up on cuttings and veg plants so that when we get the approval, we can now draw plants in that are in flowering, which is now only 8 weeks further. Therefore, on all that timing, it's expected, if these dominoes fall the way I just described, that by January, end of January of 2019, we will start the harvest, saleable harvest products, out of the expansion areas. But it's a ramp up.
Okay.
So to hit the number that you quantified will be May or June of 2019.
Oh, okay.
So every month we're going to be adding, I'm just going to pick another 4,000 keys a month, another 4,000, et cetera. By May or June, we will be producing, available for sale, 20,000 kilos a month between Aphria 1, Aphria Diamond, and Broken Coast.
Wow.
And that's a lot.
So we can pick a number.
Yep.
And just do the math ourselves is what you're saying.
No, I am going to go a little more
a little further out on the drive.
Yeah, because
gain plank.
Because we also pride ourselves in what we've been, a year and a half of engineering, design, brainstorming. Our automation in Part 4 is beyond belief.
Okay.
Every investor group, every pension fund, every analyst that we have brought to see in amazement and their jaws drop when they see how can these robots do what they're doing? How did you come up with this? Mm. Well, it was taking from this industry, that industry, this country and that country, and the team putting it all together. And it's just not my co-founders, Coley and John, it's many others in the Leamington area that really feel like they're part of the Aphria team, although they're contractors to us.
Right.
They just want to work with us. So that is really driving out a lot of costs, labor costs. Labor, I'm going to suggest to you, for any other greenhouse growers out there that are trying to double, triple their size, labor is going to be a concern as companies go forward in trying to throw in 15 or 20 people per acre of greenhouse. It's not an easy skill set to find and to retain and to train, properly train with GMP training, WMIS training, etc. So we were trying to eliminate some of the costs associated with labor, some of the headaches, automation. See, robots, they don't go on vacation. They don't get sick. Mm. They don't take time off. They don't have babysitting.
They do try to take over the world once in a while, though.
Oh, Hal?
Hal or Terminator, you take your pick.
No, my point is this. The quarter we just finished, we had 95 cent cash cost, $1.60 all in. The $1.60, there was a lot of unabsorbed overhead. When you transition, as we are, from part two to part three completions, now part four and part five, you've got a lot of, not a redundancy, you have to hire in far in advance of actual cultivation and harvesting. So that was the little blip increase in cost of goods sold. But the 95 cents, let me go back to that one. That, if we could have a circle date, which I know you will circle, that June of 2019, you and I are here, I'm going to say that my cash cost is 80 cents or lower on the cash cost because of automation. We are driving out so much labor and having robotics just being part of who we are.
Okay, well, I'll look forward to June 2019, but okay. I hope I see you again before then, Vic. Let's cut it there. We'll come back to you again shortly, and thanks for joining me again.
Great, thank you.